today we're going to be looking at a web server. Now, I love web servers. It's the easiest way to share files. You know, anyone with a web browser or any modern-day computer can download files from a web server, whether it be through a web browser or just using a program like wget or curl. And I run Apache on a lot of my systems, but Apache's kind of overkill if you just want to share some files. You can obviously tweak Netcat to share a certain file. I've done that in the past, but that's kind of cumbersome. BusyBox. I love BusyBox. It has a built-in HTTP daemon, and you can put it in anything from routers to your desktop computer to your phone. But it doesn't have a default like web directory. So to get to a certain file, people have to know the exact link to a certain file, which is fine if you're going to share that file. That's one way to do it. And you can create directory indexes for it, but then you need a separate script. You need to set up folders. It works, and it's great, but there's a simpler way. And you might be thinking, okay, Python, you can set up a simple server. One command, you run a Python command, and Python runs on almost everything, and you now have a web directory people can download from it. And yes, that's true. That is a great way to do it. But there's another option, and it's actually a Python script, so it'll run on any machine you have Python on, and it's called Wolf, W-O-O-F. And it should be in your repositories on most distributions. I'll use Aptitude to search for it. You'll see it's right here. I already have it installed. It says share files through HTTP. So it's not, it's designed for sharing files. If I man wolf, we can see here it says it's a simple, small, or a small, simple, stupid web server to share files. And it gives you options as into like what port you want to share it on. By default, it goes to port 8080. And you can also give it a count. So you can say, if you don't say anything, after the file's downloaded once, the web server stops. So you can create this thing, point it at a file, send the link to somebody, they click on it, it downloads, and the web server shuts off so no one else can download that file. You can also point it at a directory using the -z, -j, -Z, or -u options. And what that does is, now, if you were using another web server with a web directory and you wanted to share 10 files or 100 files, someone would have to click on each one of those files to download it. Well, with Wolf, you point it at a directory, give it one of these options for what compression you want, or an uncompressed tarball, and when they click on it, it sends them that compressed zip file or a gzip file or just a tar file or a bzip2 file, and it just downloads that whole directory as one file that they can then uncompress on the device. They don't have to click on 100 different links. So let's go ahead and give this a try. I'm going to quit out of the man page. I'm in a directory here from a previous tutorial that I have two mp3s and a wav file. So let's say I wanted to share this 1.mp3. What I can do is I just say wolf, once I have Wolf installed, obviously, and point it at that file. And I'll hit enter. It tells me right here that I'm running on this, my current IP address, port 8080. And again, you can specify a port if port 8080 has already been used or you want to use a different port on your machine. And now I can go here and I can type in that address. I could probably type in localhost as well, but just as an example, I'll give my local IP address here, 8080. And when I hit enter, I don't have to get a file name because it's pointing out that one file, 1.mp3, and now that's downloaded to my computer. And again, I can point, they give this link to anybody and on their phone, they click on it, it will automatically download that file. As you can see, the web server killed itself after it downloaded that file. And again, you can do -c and I can say 2, and when I hit enter now, I can go there. See, I downloaded again, and I downloaded again, and if I try to download it a third time, oh, I can't, because after two times, it turned off the web server, so the web server doesn't keep running after the file has been downloaded. Now, as another example, as I said, I can say wolf, and I'm gonna say dot for the current directory, but I can point at any directory. And I'm gonna say -z, lowercase z, which I believe was a gzip file. So it's gonna be a tarball file inside a gzip file. I'll go ahead and hit enter. And now, when I come here and I go to this link, it's going to give me a file called fm, because that's the name of the folder, .tar.gz, and I can then unzip this file like so, and I have all three of those files inside a folder, inside a file, so I didn't have to go and click on each one of those files separately or give a different link for each one of those files. So that is a quick look at Wolf, but it does a little bit more that we're going to look at in the next video. But go ahead and check this out. Again, it's a Python script, so it should run on any machine running Python. And of course, again, you can always use your Python simple server, but this gives a few other options, and we're going to get into a little bit more in the next video. I thank you for watching. Please visit filmsbychris.com. That's Chris with a K. There's a link in the description. If you enjoyed this video and if you enjoy most of my videos, think about supporting over at patreon.com/metalx1000. There's a link to that in the description. You can also support me through PayPal at my website under the support section. And at filmsbychris.com, you can also search through all my videos from both my channels. I thank you for watching, and as always, I hope that you have a great day.